wanted to say that I appreciated the testimony and the argument that was given last Friday at the sentencing hearing from both the defense and the state. Both were well done and were impactful. I've had much to consider, and I have given this case a lot of thought, and I have determined that two out of the three factors that the jury found proven beyond a reasonable doubt reasonably justify aggravating the sentence, and that an upward departure sentence is warranted. Accordingly, as I am required to do in such a circumstance, I have reduced to writing why those factors justify a departure sentence and what that sentence should be. Because I believe that I have, in that written order, set forth my findings and analysis with sufficient clarity. There's no need to belabor those points this morning. I trust that the order will speak for itself. Mr. McAllister, the clerk, has copies of the order that he will hand out after the sentence is imposed. So Mr. Haim, with you and counsel, please approach the podium. Mr. Haim, a jury of your peers, having found you guilty of second-degree murder, and for the reasons I set forth in my written order, I'm going to adjudicate you guilty of second-degree murder and sentence you to a term of life imprisonment. You have credit for the 140 days you've served. Court costs will be imposed of $253. You have 30 days to appeal both the judgment and sentence in this case, and if you cannot afford a lawyer for that purpose, I would appoint one for you.
Your Honor, we would ask at this time you appoint the public defender's office for purpose of appeal.
I will do that. Do make sure that he fills out a new affidavit of indigency. I think that is required, but I would, and now appointing the public defender's office to represent Mr. Haim. That concludes the hearing.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Do you have a copy of the financial affidavit?
Thank you.
Thank you.